Hi guys, welcome back to the home in Homestead. My name is Rebecca, and today on the Homestead, I'll be taking you with me in the kitchen while you cook with me while we make homemade tortillas. And we'll pair that with a roasted Brussels sprouts with a spicy Thai peanut butter sauce. Homemade tortillas are easy to make, and I'm sure you will find them delicious. The roasted Brussels sprouts filling that we will be making today for these homemade tortillas is a healthy option for a snack or meal. And when topped with a spicy Thai peanut butter sauce, it checks off all the boxes. It's sweet, salty, savory, and spicy. The little sour from the vinegar in the sauce, as well as that umami from the roasted Brussels sprouts. So let's get started making these roasted Brussels sprouts. So what I like to use is a deep dish stone pan. And to this I place my Brussels sprouts. And usually I just do Brussels sprouts by themselves, but I also had a half of an onion in the refrigerator that I needed to use up, so I thought I'd use that today as well. When you make your homemade tortillas and you're creating your snack or meal, it's a very versatile thing to cook with, and it's a great way to use the vegetables and meats and things like that in the refrigerator. So to this we'll add the prepared Brussels sprouts. What I mean by prepared is I cut the end stem off and remove any discolored leaves from the outside. Now I just drizzle this mixture with some oil. I like avocado oil because it has a little bit of a higher smoke point. You can certainly do olive oil. Then we'll just season with salt and pepper. This is something that you could kind of play around with. You can, if you have your favorite seasoning salt or spice blend, you could use that. I'm just going to keep it simple, let the flavors of the Brussels sprouts and onions shine here. So I have the oven preheated to 375 degrees. I'll put these in. I'll start for about probably 25 minutes and check them. Now let's move on to the homemade tortillas. So in this bowl, we have 3 cups of flour. To this, we will add 2 teaspoons of salt. And 1 teaspoon of baking powder. Now let's mix this around. What I like to do is make a little well in the middle. Then I add my wet ingredients. So I'll add 1/3 cup of neutral oil. So vegetable oil, canola oil, you can use a very light extra virgin olive oil or avocado oil. And finally, we will add 1 cup of warm water. Then I just mix to combine. This will be a nice soft dough once completed. Well, the flour is all mixed in here. So I'm going to lightly flour my surface here. We'll just turn this dough out. Just kind of combine this into more workable ball shape. Now what I like to do is just kind of roll it into a little bit more of a rectangle or just a little wider oval. And now we're going to divide this dough into its portions. So if you're planning to do tacos, this technically could make about 16 tacos if you're doing a little larger, like burrito, or you want a little larger quesadilla with these, just cut the portions to the size tortilla you eventually will want. And as you make this dough more, you'll come to know what size you prefer. So it ends up being about a golf ball size. Take the dough and make it into a ball. And I place them into the bowl that I mix them in. It already has a little flour on the edges. Work on making these portions of dough into balls, and I just put them into a bowl. By rolling these dough portions into a ball or more of a round shape, you're helping yourself in the long run, because later when we roll them out, they'll already have a little bit of a rounded shape to them. Whereas if you left them in a square, then you'd have kind of square-edged tortillas, which could be fun too, but I'm going for the round tortillas today. So here we have our bowl of the tortillas. What I'm going to do is cover that. I'll cover this and set this aside for about 20 minutes, which is perfect timing to clean up your work surface and work on the peanut butter sauce. All right, so now to our spicy Thai peanut butter sauce. Let's get all of our ingredients here. First, we're going to start with equal parts of peanut butter to rice vinegar. Make sure it's a creamy peanut butter. And you can also use a white vinegar if you don't have any rice vinegar. So I have a few tablespoons of the peanut butter there. Want to whisk these ingredients together. The vinegar will just kind of break up that peanut butter and get it more into a sauce consistency rather than that thick peanut butter in the jar consistency. Next, we'll add a half a teaspoon of red pepper flakes. If you like it spicier, add more. If you don't want it as spicy, add less or don't add any at all. And we do like things a bit spicy, so I'm going to add about a teaspoon of sriracha, hot chili sauce, and to help even out that vinegar and these spices, I'm going to add a teaspoon of sugar. Mix these all together. So it makes a rather thick sauce. If you want it a little thinner, a little more pourable onto your tacos, just thin it out with water. Let's give it a taste. Tastes good. Nice spice with those crushed red pepper flakes and the sriracha, and a little bite from that vinegar. This will pair really nicely with our roasted Brussels sprouts. So let me go check on the Brussels sprouts and see if they're ready. So I just stirred the Brussels sprouts and added a little more thyme. Now we can start rolling out these tortillas. So what I like to do is start off with maybe two or three at a time. Lightly flour your surface. I have a pan on the cooktop heated to medium-high heat. Once you get going with this, by about the time a tortilla cooks, you'll have rolled out the next one, and you can just keep going on with the process there. You can roll out like I am with a rolling pin. If you have a tortilla press, you can certainly use that as well. So these are more of a taco, even more of a street taco size, smaller taco. As I mentioned earlier when I was dividing up the the dough into the sections and then making them into these ball shapes. When you portion out, that's when you can determine what size tortilla you would like to end up with. You can roll out a little bit bigger and make for a traditional taco or for enchilada shells. You go really big and make less portions and make for burritos or large quesadillas. You can also make some tortilla pizzas with these, which is rather tasty. So you just put some pizza sauce on and some mozzarella cheese and whatever topping you'd like. And they're kind of a fun snack too. So you want the pan to be nice and hot. It's not quite ready, so I'm just going to set that off to the side. And I'll roll up the next one. This is a really easy and delicious recipe. You really taste the flavors of whatever your filling ingredient is. You can also play around with these tortillas and make a flavor tortilla. So you could do perhaps some nice dry spices and make like a herb tortilla. Or you could add some tomato paste. Or if you watched my video on dehydrating tomato scraps to make a tomato paste substitute and tomato powder, you can make a tomato flavored tortilla. They'd be great for wraps as well. All right, let's get these tortillas onto the pan for cooking. So let's place the tortillas on a medium high heat pan. You can kind of hear it sizzling a little bit. I do not have any oil or anything. This is just a dry pan. If you have cast iron, that works very well as well. So we'll let this cook on the first side for about 45 seconds to a minute. What we're looking for is little bubbles, air bubbles to show up on top. And when we flip it, it'll have little brown circles where it's starting to cook and brown. So you can see little bubbles are starting here. If you can see them on camera. Bunch of little ones here, and little bigger one here, and here, and here. This one's growing here. If you find that it's taking up much more than a minute or so, you can turn the heat up a little bit on your cooktop. Just little tiny areas of brown. Usually the first one's kind of not the prettiest, much like when you make pancakes and things. But we'll get this one finished up, and then I have here a little tortilla storage bin. You can also use just any covered dish. If you have a Pyrex with a glass lid or a Corningware, like a casserole dish with a lid, or just a bowl with a towel on top works fine. Ultimately, you want the cooked tortillas in a covered container so that they can stay warm and stay soft and steam each other as they sit in the container. The next tortilla on there. There we go, we have nice big bubbles here. There we go. So it takes about 1 minute on the first side and about 30 seconds on the second side. So while this cooks, I'm going to roll out the next tortilla and just keep going. Thank you. Okay, so the Brussels sprouts are finished. I should say Brussels sprouts with the onions. Took about 45 minutes total. I'll let them sit off to the side here and I'll keep making these tortillas. All right, guys, well, here you have it. We have some homemade tortillas. Nice and soft and steamy in the tortilla basket here. With some roasted Brussels sprouts and onions with a spicy Thai peanut butter sauce. I have a couple of them made here. I have a little taco rack, which is kind of fun for taco night. If you're having these as an appetizer for a gathering, you can pre-make some different filled homemade tacos and have them out for your guests to just pick up and grab and enjoy. So let me just give this a taste myself. That is really tasty, guys. With a soft homemade tortilla, if you haven't done so yet or haven't found the right recipe yet, give this one a try. It's a really delicious homemade tortilla. And the filling, the pairing of the roasted Brussels sprouts with the spicy Thai peanut butter sauce, it is so satisfying. And it's sweet and salty and spicy. You have a little bit of sour and the umami with the roasting effect onto the Brussels sprouts. And I added the onion today, and that's a nice addition as well. You can play around with the fillings, play around with the size of the tortillas you make based on what entree or snack that you're creating. You can really enjoy this recipe for future snacks and gatherings, perhaps a game day, Super Bowl party, holidays, or just for taco night. This would be a really fun appetizer to your traditional taco, or you could play around with the fillings and make a variety of tacos for taco night. Well, I hope you're having a fantastic day and you enjoyed our time together in the kitchen making these homemade tortillas, as well as this roasted Brussels sprout and spicy Thai peanut sauce. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel and haven't done so yet, please consider subscribing and checking out some more videos I have. I have a number of videos of recipes in the kitchen where I'm cooking various snacks and meals and a number of food preservation videos. Until then, we'll see you next time. Take care.